be the standout in Iowa tonight. Joining us now is national political reporter for Real Clear Politics, Rebecca Berg. Dagan McDowell also joining the conversation. Dagan, Rebecca, good to see you both. Thank you so much. Let me start with you, Rebecca. Who do you think wins with Trump's absence tonight?
Well, maybe Trump. And that's really the question tonight, Maria. Can Donald Trump still command the stage without even being on it? And I think it's going to be a challenge for Ted Cruz, Marco Rubio, and some of the other leaders in this race to prove that they are potential frontrunners and that they can outshine Donald Trump even when he is commanding media attention like this. So that's really going to be a challenge.
It's really interesting that you say that, because for so long, and Dagan, weigh in on this, I mean, for so long we've been talking about Donald Trump needs to get more specific. We need to hear real substance in terms of the issues. Here, the candidates have an opportunity to do a debate without him to offer that kind of substance. And Rebecca's saying, well, maybe he'll still command the stage even though he's not there.
If he's not there, and my prediction is he shows up at the last minute.
You think so?
If you want to keep this reality show going, anybody who's watched, again, The Real Housewives, NeNe Leakes, surprise appearance, comes back. Kim Zolciak, surprise appearance, comes back. He can have his own spin-off show. He's still got to be on the thing that made him, well, great. And that is the Republican race for the nomination. So I think that there's still a chance that he pops back. I love how Cruz is taking him on leading up to the debate. The Cruz campaign set up a website called duckingdonald.com.
Nice.
Saying, come back. Nice. And they're selling hats. Make Donald debate again. So
that's great. Oh, I'd love to get a hat like that. That would be awesome.
Oh my God!
I hope they take the time to really beat him up, because if you do some analysis on what his policies are, especially on the trade side, they're hugely populist, but they are the worst thing to really be enacted. If he got elected and he said he was going to do some of the things like raise tariffs 45% on NAFTA countries, we could ignite a global trade war that would come at the worst time for the stock
market. From that, Andy. He backed away from that and said, oh, I didn't mean 45. It just means if they don't do what they're supposed to be doing.
But even with this stance on China, he's beat them up constantly. This is not good.
He's got a point there. Maybe not on the tariff side, but he's got a point that if you're an American company right now, if you're a Caterpillar, for example, trying to sell tractors to Brazil or China or Japan, you are so not competitive because of the value of the U.S. dollar. Now, maybe this is not the way to fix that. It's not through tariffs. The way to fix that is not maybe even through fiscal policy, but this is a real issue that actually our companies are grappling with. We're seeing that in earnings.
Well, that's the thing. He brings up real issues, the same situation with immigration. It may not be the solution that people necessarily see as working, but he brings up these issues, and then it gets everybody talking about them, Rebecca, which is what you're alluding to, that he'll be on the stage anyway.
Exactly. And so I expect that some of these candidates are still going to have to answer for Donald Trump, still answer for the policies that he has brought into this debate, which puts them really at a disadvantage, because what Ted Cruz, Marco Rubio, and some of the others wanted to do tonight was make this about them, not about Donald Trump. And once again, he's stealing the spotlight, and that doesn't help them at all.
I cannot wait to see what Marco Rubio can do with Ted Cruz, because in your debate, and the one that you and Neil did, the very end of that debate, it was well after 11 o'clock, Rubio all of a sudden came to life and hammered Ted Cruz over and over about his conservative inconsistencies. And it was some real not knockout blows, but he's got to do that a lot earlier. He's got to bring the heat toward the beginning of the debate. Don't wait until a lot of people have gone to sleep.
Can anybody on that stage tonight take it beyond where Donald Trump has been? He's already at 40%.
I think there's a lot of opportunity for Rubio, because he needs guys to drop out. He needs Kasich to drop out, Bush, Christie. Those are more the mainstream guys. Those votes will go to Rubio. They won't go to Cruz. So it's really Cruz and Trump that are going after each other. Rubio's going to be on the side. So Rubio just needs to hit Cruz as hard as he can, like Dagan was saying. And I think that's what I'm going to be watching for.
If they talk about Trump too much, they're the losers.
Yeah.
Totally.
You're right.
Yep, it's a great point.
Rebecca, anybody you see particularly emerging right now without Trump there tonight, aside from Rubio, as we've been talking about?
Sure. Well, Maria, I'll be watching Ted Cruz on that stage. He is a great debater, as we have all seen. Obviously won championships for that when he was a student at Princeton. So we know that he is very good in this setting. Without Donald Trump, he'll have a chance to really shine, I think. And of course, the prize is Iowa, and he's in second place in some polls, tied in others. So he really needs to perform in this debate to win the caucuses.
We'll see. Big opportunity for the others on stage.
They better come loaded for bear, and yeah, they better work on their debate prep. I mean, real serious debate.
Yeah, it's true. Rebecca, thank you.